Automating little bits of content creation and live streaming is something that I'm really getting into. In a recent video, I showed you how to use your voice to create high quality clips in both portrait and landscape mode. And it's when adding a sound effect to confirm that the clip was taken that I said this.
Now, if you want to push it further, what you can do is basically record yourself. Use something like Voicemod, and you can say something like, "Jarvis, clip that." And then Jarvis will be like, "Successfully clipped," or something like that. Whatever. I give you the tools, you get creative with it.
Okay, Jarvis, I want you to imagine controlling multi-action in OBS Studio with your voice.
I think it would be pretty cool.
So here's how I would go about doing that.
So you would probably want to start by listing all of the actions that you usually take when creating content. So for your live stream, for example, you can think of key moments where you're actually going to perform multiple actions that can totally be automated. When I start my stream, I usually open up the Twitch dashboard on a separate window. I pop out the chat on a separate window. I also open up Pretzel Rocks, which is my copyright-free music app. And I also open up Speech Chat. This is my TTS for chat. When I'm taking a break, I usually switch to the break scene. I mute my mic. I turn up the music, or I play some clips. Sometimes in the middle of a stream, I have a question that I would like chat to answer. I could probably automate a quick yes or no poll. Now, for people who own a Stream Deck, this will sound familiar. This is basically multi-action. You can see that here I have start the stream in OBS, wait a couple seconds, launch the pop-out chat, open up Pretzel, and open up speech chat. So yeah, you already have that stuff. But if we're doing it through Streamerbot, it can be voice controlled, it can be chat controlled, and it's free. So all of this looks good, but we're not about hard work here. We're just gonna do the first one and then record the Jarvis voice. Okay, so let's do the actions for starting a stream using Streamerbot. I'm gonna create a new action by right-clicking and clicking add. Name it starting task. Click OK. Then under sub actions, we wanted to do everything we needed to do. Now, in order to open a website, it's pretty simple. You want to go to the website. In this case, it's my stream manager. I'm going to copy the URL. Then back in Streamerbot, under sub actions, I want to go to core system, run a program, and just paste the URL here where it says command. Click OK. And it's that simple. I also wanted to open a popped out chat so I can go back to my dashboard. Come here, click pop out chat. And we can see that the URL is quite different here. I can just copy it and do the same thing. Okay, now I want it to open up Pretzel Rocks, which is the app that I use for music. So once again, core system, run a program, except this time I'm going to click on those three little dots to go find my program. You want to find wherever that software is. In this case, I'm using a shortcut, hoping that it will work, and click OK. Finally, same thing for speech chat, copy the URL. We can test it a little bit.
Hi. Oh, hi, Mark.
Core system, run a program, bop, bop, super fast. And what else? We want to make sure that we are on the starting soon scene. I don't even have one on this OBS, but whatever. Right click OBS, set active scene, and then you want to select the scene that you want. In my case, it's called scene. Now, what I like to do is give it time to basically open up all that stuff. So give it a little bit of delay, core delay, maybe 3 seconds. Nice. And when it's done, I want it to OBS and streaming. State, start, boom.
So as you can see, creating those automations is pretty easy with Streamerbot. Now let's create the voice command that will trigger all that, and then we'll do the voiceover that will respond back to us. All right, so back in Streamerbot, we wanna go to voice control. First, you wanna go to settings and make sure that you have auto start listen. As you can see, it is currently listening, but it's actually using the wrong input. So you wanna make sure that you're using the right stuff here. In my case, I want mic in, Elgato Wave XLR, and then go back to commands. Now we can create commands. So name of the command, and then command will be the words that it's supposed to listen to in order to trigger it. I'm gonna put Jarvis initiate the stream. And location is location of the command and whatever you're saying. Should it be exactly that? Should it start with the command? Should it be anywhere in the middle of you speaking? I believe exact will work for us now. So let's click OK. And then we just need to set this as a trigger in our action. So action tab, triggers, core, voice control, command, and you select it. Starting stream auto. Click OK. And there you go. Now, I made sure that I'm on my alt account. So even if I trigger it by accident, it's not gonna be a huge deal. But I gotta admit, it's still pretty weird to be able to just start a stream like that. Actually, this is a great opportunity to show you that if you're working with commands that are that important that could just start the stream accidentally and things like that, you might not want to do that. You might not want to accidentally start the stream. You might want to test everything else but to start the stream. So you don't need to delete this. You can just right click and then click enable here. It will, well, not enable it anymore. Which means that we should be ready. I'm gonna go on a separate scene just to show you. And then I'm gonna say, Jarvis, initiate the stream. Jarvis, initiate the stream.
Jarvis, initiate the stream. So it works. It works. It just took a couple of tries, not gonna lie, but it does work. It opened up everything. Did it switch to my start? Yes, it switched to the scene that I wanted to. So technically everything worked fine. This might be dangerous because you're starting the stream, but not that dangerous because it's not stopping the stream. So I would definitely not make my end stream voice controlled. Jarvis, wait, man, no wonder it's not working. I miss it. If there's a typo, turns out it's not gonna work. How did it even trigger the first time? All right, cool. I'm glad you're here to witness all the hardships, okay? If you go through them, now you know what to do. Double check your grammar. Anyways, I think the most exciting part of this is getting Jarvis to respond. And we can do this by recording voice lines with a voice changer. And we're gonna do that by using Voicemod. This is pretty much the best voice changer you're gonna find. Please do keep in mind that I am an official partner of Voicemod. So yes, there is affiliation here. And I am using Voicemod Pro. So I have access to everything and you may not if you're using the free version. That being said, basically all of those are different voices that you can use. And that's not all. Voicemod has like soundboards and all that stuff. They even have something called community voices where there's a whole list of user-made voices that you can use. So pretty much anything you can think of will most likely be there. One of their regular voices is called Space Trooper, and I feel like it matches the theme. If you're using a free version, I believe you'll have access to a couple of voices and it will rotate. So maybe wait until you have the perfect voice, record everything you need, and then you're good. Or you can pay for a pro version. Either way.
This is what it sounds like. And wow, I love it. I have a few options here. Character, man.
Manly man. Oh. Pretty nice. Woman?
Yes, woman. Oh, I am the captain of the ship. I am the AI voice. Captain, the thrusters are damaged.
The pantry are defenses, sir.
The way Voicemod works is that it creates an extra virtual audio microphone. So when you're speaking through Voicemod, it's going to output the voice changer through that device. So we just need an audio software to record the voice lines. I personally like to use Audacity, but you can do this in anything else, really. Even OBS. I can do a test here. I can click this. Testing 1, 2, 3.
This. Testing 1, 2, 3.
And just like that, you can have a little bit of fun. I'm just gonna list off everything that it's doing. Yes, sir. Opening stream manager. Popping out the chat. Launching pretzel. Opening up speech chat. TTS activated. Stream initiated. Was that like first take?
Yes, sir. Opening stream manager. Popping out the chat. Launching pretzel. Opening up speech chat. TTS activated. Stream initiated.
Yo, this is cool, but this is so aggressive. And you can also readjust the delay that you have here based on how long the voice is going to play for. This is 11 seconds, so I could probably put it to 11 seconds here. Now I can export by going to File, Save Other, Export as MP3 or WAV, and just save it somewhere that you will find. And now in Streamerbot, let's go full screen here. You want to right click, go to Core, go to Sound, Play Sound. Click on the three little dots and go find that sound. And here it says, finish playing before continuing. So we don't want that. We actually wanted to start playing and then do the stuff while it's playing. So we're gonna turn that off. Click OK. I'm gonna drag it all the way up because I want it to start playing first, basically. I wanna make sure that all of my actions are enabled. I really don't have to do this for the tutorial, but I guess I like the theatrics. I'm gonna set this here like that so you can see what's happening. And I'm going to say, Jarvis. Initiate the stream.
Yes, sir. Opening stream manager. Popping out the chat. Launching pretzel. Opening up speech chat. TTS activated. Stream initiated.
And we're live. And we're live. Oh my. Okay, I need to cut this stream right now. Okay. Oh, I don't even have good internet enough to stream. It did say TTS activated, but you need to click to unmute TTS if you want it to work. So there it is. That's how I would go about doing this whole thing. On my Streamerbot, I can see that I still have the clip that command. So if I say chat, clip that.
Viber.
This is the sound that I had, but now I can make a specific voice for it. And it would sound like successfully clipped. Clean it up.
Successfully clipped.
Export it, then replace it. There it is. So now, not only can I clip things using my voice, but I can also get a response back when I say, chat, clip that.
Successfully clipped.
It's so fancy for no reason. All right, I think you get the point. This is just one of many ways that you can use this voice control stuff, commands, Streamerbot, opening up URLs. But hopefully now that you know how to do it, you can find ways to make it useful for your particular situation. Hopefully this was at least entertaining to watch. I'm trying to sprinkle a little bit more of entertainment in my videos instead of making boring step-by-step tutorials. So I hope you guys like it. In the meantime, go follow me on Twitch and I will see you all next time. Go out there, make me proud.
Dad level.